With me this morning from New Oil on the phone, I'm joined by Jay Bhattacherjee. Jay, good morning.
Good morning to you.
Look, an interesting update from you this morning. You've eyed up some potential reverse takeover targets. Tell us a bit more what this is all about here, Jay.
Yeah, so you know we came into the company on the 4th of November with a view to building the business into something that was more representative and long term. Something that, as I've repeatedly stated, I wanted to institutionalize the business. And you know, basically from mid last year onwards, and in specific over the last couple of weeks, the oil and gas sector has been severely depressed. And that's right across, you know, in terms of the capital markets, in terms of just the overall energy across that sector. So for quite some time now, we've been looking at opportunities which are cash flow generative and also capital markets receptive. And over the last several months, we've really been focused in on finding opportunities where not only is there government initiative to deploy capital into, but there's also, you know, social, economic benefits in both private, public sector, both mentality and just strictly in terms of money. And so we've been focused in on the environmental slash green tech sector. We've been in advanced discussions with several parties now. And you know, we've got until the 4th of May to move a transaction forward. And then obviously we want to be closing that up as quickly as possible once we do announce our preferred RTO candidate.
Can you give us any more specifics as to what you're looking at within the environmental and green tech space?
I can't really at this point in time, but what I could say is that the opportunities that we're looking at are all cash generative. They are existing businesses which have a long history in production and in operations. Again, we feel that the opportunity lies for creating a pillar, and then effectively what we're looking to do is in our RTO, we build off of the back of that. So we would like to do is create a bit of a consolidation vehicle post our RTO. So whatever we buy, we want to create that strong pillar that that allows us to be that consolidation vehicle, because the sector that we're looking at right now is either very fragmented in terms of lots of quote unquote mom and pop operations, or they're very big, just kind of use BIFA as an example, but on the side of things, and there's not really anything in between. So we feel that there's a niche opportunity there for a company like us, which is a shell company, to evaluate these types of opportunities.
And these firms, I'd imagine, are UK businesses, are they?
They are. They're UK, but they're also there's also international opportunities we'd be wanting to expand into. One of the good things about this particular sector is that it's topical capital markets receptive across the planet. Unlike many of the upstream areas where you're waiting on governments and relying on other people to do things, this is an opportunity, or these are opportunities for us to just basically drive the bus, as opposed to hoping for somebody else to drive the bus.
And is this, I suppose, to some degree an acknowledgement that the strategy at New Oil up till now hasn't been completely successful?
Look, we do get a lot of the incoming emails regarding the previous strategy, and I think it'd be inappropriate for me to probably discuss prior to our arrival into the company. What we are intending to do going forward is to drive the business into something that's sustainable and is also capital markets receptive. There's no point in continuing to keep fighting uphill in terms of industry and the deals themselves if all we're going to get is constant negativity. So the company as it stands right now is a shell. It was a shell as of the 4th of November. We had a clean slate to work with in terms of deals. We are very cognizant and very respectful of the shareholders who have shown a great deal of patience. And you know what we're trying to do is, again, build something that's sustainable longer term.
And Jay, you've got a long history when it comes to oil and gas, but the new team that's taken over, what experience have they got when it comes to environmental and green tech?
Well, it's a good question. It's a combination of two things. So any acquisition that we're doing, we're hopeful that we'll be bringing in a new CEO, a COO, along with that deal. In terms of our experience, oil and gas, you know, I do have a long history in oil and gas, but outside from that as well, not only am I an investor in a lot of other industries, but at the same time, business is business, really. And you know, as chairman of the company, it's my responsibility to make sure whatever the company does is, again, in the best interest of the shareholders. And what we want to do is also support the incoming management. We want to make sure they have the tools to be that consolidation vehicle. And whatever we as a board can do, you know, we'll be providing that support. So ultimately, the company is going to have a very well experienced management team in this sector. You know, we as a board will be providing all the support we can for not only the shareholders, but for the management as well.
And the clock's ticking, Jay, as you say. So what's that date that you've got to have made or announced an acquisition by?
I mean, the ultimate date is the 4th of November. So I know we have until the 4th of May before we get suspended, but that doesn't mean that we can't conduct the transaction straight through that. So the ultimate date being the 4th of November, but we need to announce an RTO. Well, we need to announce an RTO and close it by the 4th of November, but we would like to announce an RTO prior to the 4th of May, where we do get suspended.
And you're fairly optimistic that that's a possibility?
The board remains pretty confident that we will be able to at least announce the RTO candidate by the 4th of May.
Good to speak this morning, Jay. Thanks very much.
I really appreciate it, and just want to thank you for your time, and stay safe out there with all this wild times going on.